Embolic strokes may originate in the heart, aorta, or large arteries, depending on where the cause is located. Types of ischemic stroke. Three of the most common types of brain ischemia include thrombosis, embolism, and hypoperfusion. Let's first discuss the thrombosis. Local in situ occlusion of an artery is what is usually meant when we use the term thrombosis. Arteriosclerosis, dissection, or fibromuscular dysplasia may be the cause of the occlusion. Strokes caused by thrombosis may be classified as having either large or small vessels. These two forms of thrombosis are important to differentiate because of their distinct causes, outcomes, and treatments. In the large extracranial and intracranial arteries that feed the brain, atherosclerosis is by far the most prevalent cause of in situ local disease. If a patient is suffering from thrombosis, the neurologic symptoms may fluctuate, subside, or worsen in a gradual manner. The second cause of brain ischemia is embolism. Embolism is a term used to describe an obstruction of arterial supply to a specific brain area caused by debris from elsewhere. Embolic strokes may originate in the heart, aorta, or large arteries, depending on where the cause is located. The embolus suddenly blocks the recipient site so that the onset of symptoms is abrupt and usually maximal at the start. Unlike thrombosis, various locations within distinct vascular territories may be affected when the source is the heart, such as the left atrial appendage or left ventricular thrombus or aorta. And the last is systemic hypoperfusion. Systemic hypoperfusion is a more widespread circulation issue that affects the brain and maybe other organs. Patients with systemic hypoperfusion have decreased cerebral blood flow that is more widespread and does not impact just one area. Neurological symptoms are often broad and nonspecific, unlike the other two types of ischemia. The neurologic manifestations are usually bilateral, although they might be asymmetric if there is prior asymmetrical cerebrovascular occlusive disease. Well, that's all. Despite the fact that almost all patients with an ischemic stroke will suffer from identical neurologic deficits, the treatment they get will vary depending on the etiology of their stroke. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button at the bottom of the page before you go. To see more of our videos, click here.